What if I told you that one group of boys from Everett could assemble a basketball team so amazing they would go down as legends forever? This is the Sauce Monkey story. The dream was alive. Produced by ESPN Studios. Today we'll recap the historic championship run of the Everett Sauce Monkeys. Please prepare yourself for greatness.
David, tell us a little bit about how the Sauce Monkeys came to be.
Well, it all started last summer when me and Isler had an idea. We had decided that high school basketball was becoming a bit too easy for us as we both averaged over 40 points a game starting on the varsity team. We won the state championship and national championship. We needed some change. So we thought about it, but college wasn't the right fit. Although we both had offers from Duke and Kentucky, we just thought that would be too easy. So we settled on a boys and girls club team. The first step to creating a great team was a great coach, and Don Anderson was our man.
What did Coach Don mean to you and this team?
He was like a father to me, you know, my dad, not really there all the time, but Coach Don, he just really gave me advice, life advice, did a great job coaching the team, running drills every practice, running us so hard, you can see from these toned thighs right here.
You're hot!
Here we can see the Sauce Monkeys running one of Coach Don's famous plays. Uncle Tim, watch and learn.
Isaiah, what was the most memorable part of the season for you?
For me, it was the parade after we won the championship, where millions of people came out to Seattle and we took that bus ride through the city, through crowds of people. That was really like important to me, and I appreciate you guys coming out. Rep up Sauce Monkeys.
How did the tragic news of Nick Valesky's death really impact you guys as a team this season?
So, coming into the season, having just made the Sauce Monkeys, greatest team of all time, getting our first couple practices, and we were really bonding as a team. And one thing that stood out was Nick. He was an amazing player, like all around. I can't keep a straight face, that's not true. And then like a couple of weeks into the season, our MVP Isler takes Nick out on a skiing trip. I don't know if this was on purpose or not, but Nick comes back dead. End it there, does that?
Nick, what has gone on in your life the past year? You were rumored to be dead and not on the team this season. What happened?
Well, a few weeks into the season, I was balling up on Isler Anderson. Took me skiing, he just took me out. He knew I was going to take his MVP title. Heartbroken.
How do you think this season would have gone differently if you were on the team?
8-0, triple doubles every game.
A fat wiener.
40 points per game. The normal.
Technically, I'm not supposed to be within 100 feet of this elementary school, but today is a special day.
So, Andrew, what was your most memorable moment of the season?
You know, I drew up a play for Isler Anderson to shoot 5 threes in a row, and they all went in. And, you know, not a lot of people give me credit for it, but it was all me.
You know, coming into our first game, I think we knew we were in for a battle. The other team had some really good players. Mario and African John was a really good all-around scorer. We prepared hard at practices, doing a lot of fun mini games and bowling to ready ourselves for this game. I think we came in well prepared, but the result wasn't really the way we wanted. With 10 seconds left, we were down by one and we had the ball. I got the ball off the inbounds, took a few dribbles, dribbled past African John and put up the floater. It hit back rim and bounced out, so we lost that game.
So during your guys' big 5-game win streak, you had one game that stood out individually for you. What was that like?
Well, we were playing against Arlington in either the fourth or the fifth game of the season.
And the first half, shooting free throws was real hard. The other team's bench was moaning every time we took a shot. And our team was really getting flustered. We couldn't make anything. But going into the half, in the huddle, you know, coach came up to me and he said, "We're not going to win this game on one shot. We can't just shoot three-pointers." And you know what I said? I said, "Coach, shut up." I went out there in the second half, hit 5 three-pointers right in a row, put us up by 10 points. It was crazy, man. It was one of the most amazing experiences I've ever had.
Reese, what do you think your biggest impact was on the team this season?
So, I know a lot of my fans are going to expect me to say all the threes that I made coming in the playoffs in double overtime, triple overtime. You know, all those threes I made to win games? But actually, what I feel most accomplished doing is cheering from the bench. Like, normally I'll start on the bench, play second quarter bench, play third quarter bench, play fourth quarter bench, and then if we go into overtime, I might get a little bit at the end. But I may, like, a couple of clutch shots, but mainly I like go from the bench, be like, "El Drano, and let's make some threes, Sauce Monkeys," and a lot of my signature cheers that people know and love. So being voted most inspirational to me felt like the greatest honor, even more than MVP, because this is better than MVP.
The Sauce Monkeys really inspired me, and just it was a privilege to watch them play, and they gave me a new perspective on the game of basketball itself and reinvented the game of basketball.
Nathan, what are your thoughts on Andrew being named assistant coach of the team?
Well, honestly, I think he's absolute trash and he smells like butthole, but I mean, he has a hot girlfriend, so I'm okay with it.
What do you remember the most about this season?
Just the family bonding. Every practice, we would all just strip down to our shorts and just give big family hugs, and it made me feel so warm and fuzzy inside. Like,
you know, looking back on the season, most memorable part to me wasn't the fact that I won MVP, you know, leading the team in scoring, assists, you know, pretty much carrying everyone on offense and defense. Actually, now that I think about it, that was the best part of the season. Even though we won the championship game, it really was me who led the team in everything.
What do you have to say to all the people out there who voted for Eiler over you for MVP?
Man, congratulations, Eiler. You played good this season, but you were kind of a ball hog. I deserved that MVP. I had more players of the game than you. I had more banked threes than you, and I was overall better than you.
So, Don, tell me, what was your most memorable moment of the season?
Most memorable moment of the season is when, I think it was like maybe the second game, and it was a very tight game. Maybe we were down by one or two with like less than a minute to go. And some of the fans were asking me to call a timeout, but Eiler and I were going to the Seahawks game, and I told the team ahead of time, "I'm not calling any timeouts because we have to get to the playoff game." So we ended up losing. Maybe a critical play called by the coach could have won the game, but Al and I had a great time at the Seahawks game. We had all the free popcorn and food you can eat, and it was against Detroit, and not that we like to lose the Sauce Monkey game, but it was fun. So that's probably my most memorable. It may not be a good memory, but it's most memorable.
Sauce Monkeys on four. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Sauce Monkeys!
Plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel this so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens, but no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine just on the night, like the 4th of July, 'cause baby you're a firework. as you should.